how to find the second last record from a table in SQL Server. Hi, I am M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. In this video, I am going to show you how can we fetch the second last record from a table. So before directly going into the topic, let me explain you in detail what exactly is the concept of explaining you this particular question and making this video. So when I'm talking about the records, if you would like to show from a table, so there might be the scenarios that you will face in your interviews, most probably in the interviews, these kind of questions. Many of those people who already have a knowledge on SQL Server, most of them, you think that if you want to see or if you want to fetch the maximum price or the maximum value from a table, then we use max function. If you want to fetch the least value from a table, then we go with the minimum function. But what if the case, if you would like to pick the information, if you would like to pick a row in between a table, okay? Now that is a difficult question. So in the same way, many of those interview questions nowadays, they are coming in this way. You don't show me the maximum record from a table. You don't show me the minimum record from a table, but they are asking me in a very interesting way, in order to confuse the interviewers. Okay, so the point is that do not get confused. Most of the questions in SQL are very, very, very simple. Just you need to think it in a logical way. What is the question? The question is that I would like to fetch the second last record from an employee table. So what is my, for example, if I keep the word second, let us keep the word second aside. Let us talk about the last record from an employee table. So for example, employee table, if I'm considering, let me first order it. If I order it in a descending order, then bigger value to the smaller value. If I'm ordering it in ascending order, smaller value to the bigger value. Am I right? So if the question is asked, show the record or fetch the information from any table, you know, which is the last record. So for that, first you order it, then you fetch what is the last record. Okay, that is one way. Now the question here I'm asking to you is that I want to see what is my second last record. For example, I will also give you an example. Let us take a fruit shop. In that fruit shop, you are buying bananas, you are buying apples, and you are buying watermelon. Okay, first you have purchased banana, then you have purchased apples, then you have purchased watermelon. So as per sequence, banana goes number 1, apple goes number 2, watermelon goes number 3. Now if I talk about the first record, then that is banana, and if I talk about the last record, that is watermelon. But the question is that I want to see the record of apple. Okay, so this is the second last record. So from last, if we count the second last record, I would like to see it. So for that, what is the query? How should we write the query and how should we get the solution out of it? That I'm going to show it to you. So for this, I have considered the table called KnowHow Employees. So if you carefully observe, we have this KnowHow Employees table where we have employee ID column, employee first name column, employee last name column, employee gender column, and employee salary column. Okay, so we have 5 columns. So if we carefully observe these 5 columns and the values that we have in this particular table, Raj, Karnav, Rinsi, Krupali, Ajay, Asif, Gaurav. For Raj and Karnav, we have employee ID 1. For Rinsi and Krupali, we have employee ID 2. For Ajay, Asif, and Gaurav, we have employee IDs 3. So this employee ID 3 will, if I make it in an order, in a descending order, then the 3 goes into the first place. All 3s will go into the first place. First place is Ajay, Asif, Gaurav, then comes with Rinsi and Krupali, then comes with Raj and Karnav. No, if I order it in a descending order. So that's how it works. Now understand that the question is that I want to fetch the second last record from this employee table. So what is the second last record from last? Second one, this is the one. So this record I would like to fetch it in the output. So what is the query? How should we write the query for this type of question? So for this, let me explain it to you in a very easy way. There might be many ways, but this way is the best in order to solve this type of question. So I am writing a select statement. In this select statement, let me choose the employee ID column, which I would like to see in the output. I would like to see employee first name column, which I would like to see in the output. Then I would like to see the employee salary column. I would like to see only these three particular columns in the output when we have five columns. So I would like to take all these columns from which table? No, that is also the important question. From which table? So from which table do we have it? No, I know that we have it from KnowHow employees table, but rather than directly writing the table name, what I am doing, I am opening up my parenthesis and I am writing another query. I am using the concept of subqueries to solve this particular question. I am using the concept of subqueries in order to solve this type of question. So as soon as you open up the bracket and you close it inside the query, that is a subquery, and the one which is outside the subquery, that is a main query. So now I am writing my subquery. I am opening the bracket, select, I am writing a select statement, I am choosing star where every table, comma. Here I am using a function called row number. I am choosing a row number function here because I would like to assign the row numbers to my particular values that I have in the table. So I am assigning this row number over what? I am assigning this row number over my employee ID. So in what order? That order you have to mention it. Order by. Order by to which column? Order by to the employee ID column. In which order you would like to apply it? I would like to apply it in a descending order. Okay. So I would like to give some name to it for this particular one. That's why I'm using as row number. That's a simple name that I would like to give it. Now I have selected this employee ID and all these. Okay. From as I mentioned the star here. Okay. Star here and the employee ID. Okay. From which table? Okay. From KnowHow employees table. Okay, that's from where I have taken it. KnowHow employees table. So I have closed my subquery. Okay, I have closed my subquery. Again, if you see here, there are still the red marks here. No, I did not mention from which table I have considered this employee ID, employee first name, and employee salary. Right? That is the reason it's showing red. So as I have already considered the KnowHow employees particular table under my subquery, I'll just give some another name to it in a short way so that it is indirectly indicating that all these three columns are considered from the KnowHow employees table. Now I am giving it the condition. Now this condition matters a lot. Here I am using where condition. In this where condition, first let me assign from which table I am considering all this. So I am considering all this from KnowHow employees table, where I have given a very short form of it, or I can call it an alias name. So dot, now I am assigning the row number to it, is equal to, what do I need? I need the second last record, right? I need the second last record. That's where I am writing the number 2 here. Okay. So before directly explaining it to you with the entire particular query, first let me show you and execute it, the subquery. So I am just executing my subquery, and as soon as I execute it, we see that a row number is assigned with a descending order. As you can see that the descending order has come here, right? So the first place goes to Ajay, second goes with Asif, third goes with Gaurav, fourth goes with Rinsi, fifth goes with Krupali, sixth goes with Raj, and seventh one goes with Karnav. So now the point is that I would like to see the second last record. So second last record is whose? It is for Asif. So row number will assign the row numbers. It will, by the order that we have given, then it will filter out the condition which we are about to see. So when I execute this complete query, then we get Asif record as a second last record from our particular question. Okay. So in the place of second last record, if you would like to see the fourth last record, just give 4. So now if I execute it, so what is the fourth last record? Fourth last record is Rinsi. So let us see if I execute it, if we'll get Rinsi or not. I got Rinsi's. Are you getting me? So this is the very easiest way of solving this kind of question. How to find the second last record from a table. So now I have considered here employees table. I have considered employee ID salary column and employee first name column. In your particular scenario, when you are facing this kind of question, the table might be different, but the concept is same. So this is how a second last record from a table can be fetched out using SQL Server. Now there might be many such situations where you might get how to find out the first, fourth last record, second last record. You need to follow the same procedure. Using a subquery will give the very easy way of answering this type of questions in SQL Server. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.